boys and girls, may the Lord bless you, and I believe that God will never forsake you. Today is a great day, and we are going to read the words of God and study the words of God. Let us pray before we study the words of God. Dear Lord Jesus, thank you for the great day. Lord, may you bless us and be with us today. Anoint your servant that let all of us that share and listen to your words, we are strengthened by your words. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise the Lord. And I hope that you are well at home and study and be a good boy and a good girls and committed in your study. All right? Okay, today we like to read one of the beautiful words of God. And I would love and I like to ask Brother Ezekiel to help me to read the Bible verses in Proverbs 23 and verse 5.
Labor not to be rich, 'tis from thine own wisdom. Will those set thine eyes upon that which is not? For riches certainly make themselves wings, they fly away an eagle toward heaven.
Okay, the Bible teaches today that labor not to be rich, 'tis from their own wisdom. Meaning that, alright, a lot of people say that I want to be rich, but I am using my own understanding. I'm using my own way. And then the Bible say that if your eyes is set upon riches only in the world, and then that money or the wealth will be what? Will be fly away as an eagle towards heaven and towards anywhere. So meaning that as a young boys and girl, before I became a Christian, sorry, I was like your age, 14 years old, 15 years old. Back then, when I was a teenage, my mom and daddy was very poor. So my dream and my wish is to make more money and to be rich, to be a successful businessman or to be an engineer, to make a lot of money for my mom, to please my mom. But that was back then, before I know who Jesus is. So today when I think back when I was a teenage, my ambitious, my wish is just to be a rich man. But since after I became a Christian, God changed me and give me understanding. Why? Because the Bible said that if you are always wish to make money and to cheat and to lie because you want to be rich, one day you will be regret. So today I want to encourage you boys and girls. Remember, we must not having this worldly mindset. We must have, you know, our heavenly mindset and knowing that whatever in this world will not last forever. But whatever you do for Jesus and you seek His kingdom and His righteousness, and you are going to have eternal life. So today, please understand, you must work hard to be successful. Yes, you must work well to be a engineer or doctor. Nothing wrong. But don't love the world and don't love the money. And you sell away your integrity. You sell away your honesty. You sell away, you know, whatever you think that is not important because of money. And you lie. So this is no good. And I'm going to read the Bible, say in one of the verses in Psalm 118 and verse 8, right? Okay, please, yes, Gil.
Psalms chapter 118, verses 8 to 9. It's better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. It's better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in princes.
A lot of people say that, oh, I want to put my trust in man, in human being. My father is rich. My mother is smart. I put my trust only in my mom and dad. That is wrong. You must put your trust in the Lord. Thank you, Lord, for blessing my mom and dad. My dad is a very successful businessman. Thank you, Lord, for blessing my mom. My mom is a very successful dentist. So we are glorifying God and we trust in God. Protect our mom and dad healthy. Protect our mom and dad, you know, intelligence, and protect my mom and dad. It has a great, great job. So you must remember to trust the Lord. We love our mom and dad, of course, 100%, but we put our trust in the Lord. And the Bible say it is better to trust in the Lord than put confidence in princess. Oh, you say, oh, my friend is a princess, my friend is a princess daughter, or my friend is a very rich man's son. So it's good that if I have a richest a friends, you know, then they can help me. But it's not right. Your trust is not in princess. Your trust is not in man, but your trust is in the Lord. Every day I encourage you to pray for your mom and dad. Thank you, Lord, for blessing my mom and dad. Please give them a good health. Bless their business, bless their job. Lord, thank you, Lord. I love you, Lord. I put my trust in you. May you protect my mom and dad. So today, I want to encourage you. These two simple Bible verses, let us remember, our trust is in the Lord, not in human being. Our trust is in the Lord because He is going to grant us a wisdom and understanding for us to be a good student, for us to study well and to achieve a good mark, to be a good student. May God bless you. God love you. And I know Jesus never forsake you. Let us pray. Dear Lord Jesus, thank you for today, Lord. We know that our trust is not in this world, but our trust is in you. Bless us, Lord, to be a good student. Grant us a wisdom and a knowledge to study well, Lord, to achieve a good mark, to pass the exam. May you bless our mom and dad. We love them, Lord. We cannot live without them, Lord. Protect them, Lord. Give them a good health. Thank you, Jesus. We also pray for our teachers. Be with our teachers, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
In Christ alone will I glory, though I could pride myself in battles won. I've been blessed beyond measure, and by His strength alone I overcome. Oh, I could stop and count successes like diamond in my hands, but those trophies could not equal to the grace by which I stand. In Christ alone I place my trust and find my glory in the power of the cross. In every victory, let it be said on me, my source of strength, my source of hope in Christ alone. In Christ alone do I glory, for only by His grace I am redeemed.